the next?
Oh, yes, sure.
Yeah, I'll give the feedback on it.
Yes, sir.
Okay, over to you.
So I should call out the names who are going to present?
Yes, yes. Just message in the group as well. Call out the name. Let them come.
Give
the presentation. Yes. And I want in a student side also, in every presentation, at least a one student post-presentation, give your feedback. What you think about the presentation.
Okay.
So
yes,
that
sir.
Name also randomly you can say post-presentation, anyone name. Okay.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Yeah.
Also, I'm ready with my presentation.
Sorry?
I'm ready with my presentation.
Yeah, yeah. Anyone can start, but yeah, that you guys can decide.
Okay.
I just want this class to more into auto run, but yeah, I am present and I'll give you my feedback.
Okay. Yes, sir. Can Spooti Bulavaram start presenting? I think there's some internet issue. Okay. Suvarna Sharma.
Sir, I actually did not make the PPT.
Okay. No problem. Then Kushi BR.
Hello. Am I audible?
Yeah, you're audible.
Yeah, I was not there in the last two classes, so like I don't know what's going on.
Okay, no problem.
Okay,
Anuja,
we can move to next.
Yeah, no problem. Anuja?
Yes.
Yeah, okay, thank you.
Let me see my screen.
Yes.
Hello, am I audible?
Yes.
Yeah,
yes. Yes.
Yeah. So first of all, I would like to say about the innovation of microwave oven. And the microwave was invented by Percy Spencer in 1946. He was tasting a new vacuum tube. When he noticed that a chocolate bar in his pocket had melted, he then tested that tube with egg, and the egg actually exploded. So, and after that, he thought about this microwave. The energy couldn't escape. It created a high density electromagnetic field. Therefore, cooking the food in a short amount of time. So this is the story of invention of microwave. Actually, microwave uses a magnetron to generate microwave energy. Magnetrons are the cross-filled tube in which electric and magnetic field crosses. That run perpendicular to each other. So this is the first image is the vacuum tube. And after that, the second image and third image is the first microwave, invention of first microwave. And the third is the box microwave. And the third is a window.
Anuja, actually, your voice is a little feeble.
Hello?
It's audible, but it's feeble. Yeah.
Am I audible now?
Yeah, now it's
yes,
clear.
Yes, you are audible, but your voice is a bit low.
Yeah,
but
yeah,
it's fine.
Now it's fine.
Okay, so this is the story of microwave. And now the touch screen comes in the microwave oven. So the second is the innovation of vehicle. Earlier there were no vehicles. So human beings used to travel from one place to another with animals, like the wild horse or elephant or camel or anything. So, and after that, the cart was added with the animal. And after that, a Roman chariot. And after that, Ford's quad cycle was invented. Ford's first car is not so much horseless carriage as a horse crossed with a carriage. It has its own gasoline engine and fuel tank and four bicycle wheels instead of four legs of horse. Its top speed of 32 km per hour is the only third of a horse's. And after that, in 1908, Model T Ford first invented a car. Ford Model T combines speed, practicality, and simplicity. Its 20 horsepower gasoline engine can race to speeds of 72 km per hour. And then in 1930, car radio was added in the car. Then in 1934, coil spring suspension. In 1949, car keys. In 1951, power steering. In 1953, air conditioning. In 1958, cruise control. In 1971, ABS technology. In 1974, digital dashboard display was added. In 1988, airbags was added. In 2000, GPS and hybrid cars were invented. In 2001, Bluetooth. In 2002, reversing camera. In 2003, automatic parking. In 2014, Tesla autopilot. And in 2020, self-driving car was invented. After that, I would like to go with innovation of food materials. Yeah. Early ones used to eat like raw vegetables, fruits, and animal skin without cooking, without cook. So after the discovery of fire, they started cooking their food. And after that, there are so many food was evolved, like chocolate cupcake, chocolate mousse, and so many. And after that, there are so many foods like sushi, cakes, and so many. And after that, the ready-to-cook food came. And QR codes on food packaging came. It gives the consumers a better idea of what product is all about. And last, thank you.
It was really nice. It was very informative. I really like this.
Thank you.
No problem. Okay. Anyone else who is ready with their presentation can actually.
Can I present?
Yeah, sure.
Okay. So I'm audible, right?
Yes, you are audible.
Okay. So instead of doing the evolution of different products, I decided to showcase 10 products which are really simple in nature. They're not very mechanized, but at the same time, they're really innovative. They're very useful. So the first thing that I have are these magnetic strips. So basically, it's based on strength. And if you have any metallic bottle cap, you can just stick it up to it and it'll stay there in your fridge. So you have like a lot of room for the rest of your products. So people use it to hang beer bottles or even ordinary bottles, since they are essentially made of metal. So it just sticks up there and you just have a lot of room in your fridge. So this is like really simple, but at the same time, it's super duper useful. The second thing I have is this AeroGarden. So this is based on artificial lighting. It basically helps your indoor plants to grow. Although indoor plants do not essentially need a lot of sunlight, they do require some amount of light to grow. And I think so everyone has experienced some of their indoor plants dying, and this prevents that from happening. Like, indoor plants are pretty expensive, and to keep them alive is also another challenge. So it's pretty simple. You have a pot, a very sleek looking pot along with lights on top, which just helps them to keep alive. The third thing I have is this portable charger. So basically these are the chargers that charge with the help of solar light. I have a calculator which is based on 2 power mode. So the calculator charges on battery as well as solar energy. So similarly, if you do have a charger which is based on solar energy, it will help you, especially when you go outdoors, if you go into the wild and you have to use your phone, because you can't really carry your charger everywhere since there might not be electricity or even a port available. Moreover, this is very conservative. This is more towards energy conservation since you're directly using solar energy. The fourth product is basically a spinner that spins your brushes in water. So this is sort of somewhere down the line based on centrifugal force, which removes the dirt.
For all of you. Hello, students.
Yes, sir.
Yeah, I mean, right now she's not audible for me.
Sir, she's audible for me.
So Janvi, she's audible for you?
Yes, sir, she's audible.
But rest, all of you are audible apart from her.
Oh.
Yeah, you are audible very clearly. But her voice is not audible for me.
Okay, but when she was presenting, I could hear her.
No, that time I can hear, but right now, is she done now?
No, sir, can you hear me right now?
Yeah, please. Now you are audible. Now you're. I think you have done so. I thought you are speaking and I'm not able to hear you.
But carry sir, on. Could you hear me like before?
Yes, I could hear you before.
Okay, all right. So the fourth product is basically a brush. Again, this is based on electricity. You just clutch in your brush in there and you spin it around in water. So it just removes all the dirt. You can use it in any brush, your makeup brushes, which a lot of people have a hard time cleaning with, or even your paint brushes. Now the fifth one is a silicone paw cleaner. If you have a pet, you would know how difficult it is to be with them because they keep shedding their hair or their paws keep getting dirty. So this one is super easy. You just put it in their paw and suck it out. And there's also another product like this, which it has like a sticky rubber around it, and you can clean off the pet's hair from anywhere. So this one is similar to that, which cleans up the pet's paw. The fifth one is something that is very, very popular, especially among people who are social media influencers or even content creators. So they often use this artificial ring light, which is pretty huge. And this is more popular in photo shoots, but these are the ones that you can just stick in the back of your phone, or you can just stick it, just clump it up at the head of your phone. So it sort of like replicates the artificial lighting, and this is very portable, easy to carry, and it's based on batteries, so you don't even have to worry about charging it. The sixth one is a digital measuring tape. This one is again based on a calculator. The more you pull the tape, the more the measurement will be seen on the screen. So often there's a lot of trouble between understanding the measurements. So directly on the monitor screen, the measurement will appear. The seventh one is a portable mosquito repeller. Now this uses the DWT-free formula. And this is sort of like the more mechanized version of an Odomos, which is obviously a lot more efficient. Basically, this is completely mechanized. You don't even have to use a charger for it. It basically removes this kind of scent, which keeps bugs and mosquitoes away, and since the size is so big and since it is mechanized as well, this is going to be a lot more powerful and efficient than our ordinary mass mosquito repellers. Now the eighth one is an eyeglass holder. It's basically like a safety clip which you can clip on to any of your clothes. Now this can be magnetic or it can even be a pin based clips, but you can hang your glasses there anytime. And I think so, most of the dresses do not really have the facility of having a pocket, or you might not always carry a purse with you. So if you have something so tiny, which is not visible to everyone, but at the same time, it can hold something so huge, I think so, it will make it a lot more convenient to have it on your clothes. The third one is an e-bike. So this is basically like an evolution itself. Initially, I think so, the first electronic transportation that I came across was the Reva car, also known as a toy car. But people liked the idea so much that Reva evolved to E2O, which is a bigger version of it. And even these Yulu bikes, which are in and around the city, it started up with these electric tiny scooters. And right now there are electric scooters as well, which people under the age of 18 can ride. So you don't really need a license for it. And again, this is a lot more efficient. You do not use fuel for it. You can directly use it with electricity. The last one is a bio fire space. Usually in modern apartments, you can hardly equip a very classic fireplace that runs on wood. And maybe not in India, but a fireplace is pretty essential in some colder countries. So if you have an apartment that is relatively small, you can use these kind of fireplaces which do not even need a chimney. So these bio fireplaces are obviously named after the usage and are very environment friendly because they use ethanol, which is a fuel that is produced from sawdust. And since it is stainless, obviously you won't even get any sense of odor, and it'll be smokeless. So it'll be similar to a wax candle, and at the end of the day, you know that you have a fireplace that is harmless. So I think so, this is very innovative because a lot of people do not have a very huge traditional chimney fireplace. Yeah, that is it. Thank you.
Yeah, it was awesome. Like, it had some really innovative stuff, and yeah, it was awesome.
Thank you.
Really good. And I see, I was keep telling you guys, you have a very good potential. And this way, if we work from here, I'm sure we'll have unbelievable result. You know, you guys can get the any of the result after a year, like, you know, wherever you want to go in IT and IT and IFT. So very nice, very nice.
So, could I present now my presentation?
Yeah, why not? Why not?
Okay.
I really am liking it, the way you guys are doing it all. Like, you know, it's really cool.
Thank you, sir. Okay. Please give me a second.
Yes, take your time. Sia, are you here? No.
Sir, she messaged me. She said she's not able to join.
Why?
I don't know, sir. I put it on the chat box, though. Send it to you privately.
Just tell her to try, because she messaged me just before the class. Still, I'm not able to join. She is messaging me. What happened? Sign in to join. Leave meeting. Oh, email.
Yeah.
You need to, she need to log in.
Yeah, okay. So that's what happened to me.
Guys, please call one of you, call her and help her.
Yeah, okay, sir. Sure.
She is not logged in her Gmail. That's what she is having an issue. Just help this here, okay? Someone please call this here. Okay. I think you are ready now. You can start me.
Yes, sir. Can you see my screen?
Still, yeah, now it is feasible. Yeah.
Okay. Yeah, so I'm going to be talking about two things, that is the evolution of human nature and the evolution of animations. So yeah, we can begin. So what makes humans different from other animals? It is an old question and one which many have given up as meaningless or unanswerable. The simple fact of our unparalleled range and adaptability as a species cannot be denied. And indeed, we seem to feel that we are special for many more reasons than that. One response to this instinct is to resist it. Having evolved like all other animals, our weird and wonderful panoply of behaviors is the result of neither individual creativity nor cultural supervenience, but is instead the simple product of millions of years of evolution, like the mating dance of birds or the territorial display of octopi. If they seem unintelligible or even maladaptive, that is simply because evolution is very slow. Our minds are adapted not to our present environment, but to the long vanished world of our ancestors. Cosmite and Tubi, 2003. It may seem to us that behaviors such as joining religious cults, suicide bombing, and racial prejudice are as irrational as they are undesirable, but in fact, on the account offered by standard evolutionary psychology, they are perfectly intelligible as the result of our Stone Age minds misfiring and triggering behaviors that were adaptive a long time ago. As humans evolve, their thoughts do too, which leads to the creation and innovation. As we evolve, I feel we are more open to change of things around us. Change is what brought us to this stage where creativity is appreciated. Moving on to the next evolution is the evolution of animation. The early animation films were crude, made with devices that were relatively simple and primitive. The first such system was called the theater optique, invented by Emily Reynaud and patented in 1888. His series of animated films include The Poff Pirate and The Otter de Une Cabane. Each of his films contain 300 to 700 frames painted images to last 10 to 15 minutes. In traditional animation history, hand-drawn animation was created using cell animation. Cell was a transparent sheet consisting of cellulose, nitrate, and camphor used to create hand-drawn objects. Characters were drawn on the cells and superimposed on common background images to reduce the number of frames and production times. Colonel Hezaliah was the first animated cartoon series created using the animation technique. The production house was John Bray Studios. Sorry for the extra. Although the first few computers animated films were very basic, to say the least, it nevertheless changed the way animation was done. Hummingbird was the first computer-generated animation film. It was made using 30,000 images and 25 motion sequences generated by computer. So you can see the difference between an old animation film and a few recent animation films. So this is how the evolution has taken place.
Going with the gut, never had a doubt, felt like this is just a must. Put me in perspective, I'm the deepest in the cut. Everybody tuning in, but this is just for us now. We know I ain't balling yet, hoes wanna holler, oh no.
Yeah, so this was just a speed art on an animated figure. So yeah, thank you.
Hello, am I audible?
Yes, sir.
Yeah, Janvi.
Yes, sir.
Yeah, it is. Where you make this PPT? I mean, on which software?
Sir, there's like a website called Canva. Yeah, there.
Canva, yes. Canva, the ready pattern is there. But very nice, you know. In fact, college students, they also use Canva. But I believe you guys to explore more like PPT, okay? There, you use your own colors and all. So what will happen? Here, it's everything is ready. You just need to put the content in Canva, right?
No, actually, I made the template.
Oh, you made the template also. Very nice. Very nice. Canva, most of the things is ready template. You need to put the everything. But
yeah,
anyway,
but they would match mostly.
Yeah, yeah. So colors and everything. But it is very nice. Well done. You all explore this also. I personally like it. I like all three of your work. Till now, three of you have presented. Yeah. So, and the good way, it's like, you know, you are leading it, then giving a feedback also. So obviously, someone, I see the deep research, someone, I see the good presentations. So everything matter. That's what we learn from each other's, right? Somebody have done the research, so that give you, okay, this way I can go for, right?
Yes, so, sir.
It's very good. It's very good. We have given a lot
sir,
of make me happy. Yeah.
Sorry to interrupt, but Sia isn't able to join.
Region?
It keeps asking her to sign in. She signs in and then it again does not allow her to join.
One second. Your voice is audible, but yeah. Could you please speak again?
The Zoom is asking her to sign in and she did and then it again asks her to sign in.
Oh. Somebody is needed from our team to help. Do you guys have Naveen sir number? Hello? Shruti ma'am, Naveen sir, anyone number you are having?
Sir, I have Shruti ma'am's number.
Yeah. So you just call Shruti ma'am or Naveen sir, by the way, and tell them to help Sia because I'm in the class, so we have to see here also the work. So meanwhile, let's see what is her problem. So team should help her. So they will check once. Call Shruti ma'am or maybe Naveen sir. Ideally Naveen sir, because he's having a class from 7. So he's there right now. And he can also help. And maybe you guys back in team too, you don't know. Anyway, I will tell here itself right now. Let me check who is there. Yeah. Let me inform the team. Yeah, next guy. I can start. I'll inform the sir. Janvi, our today's host.
I'm sorry.
Start next. Who is next?
Okay. Yes, sir. Can Anushka Chaudhary present her PPT or PDF?
Yeah, 1 minute.
Yeah.
Is the screen visible?
Yeah, your screen is visible.
Okay. So I'll be first talking about the evolution of pen. So the first quill pen is a writing tool which is made from a light feather and which uses ink to leave marks on a writing surface. This was basically invented in 19th century. But later on, what happened was that steel pen points were introduced, which is fountain pen. It was invented by the Petrarchi Ponaru and Robert William Thompson. So the fountain pens basically allowed, the natural ink flow from the ink reservoir through the nib. Later on, what happened that John J. Loud invented the ball pens. Ball pen basically in 1880 century that dispenses over a metal ball and its point at its point. So basically, over a metal ball which has at its nib, the ink comes out, and it is very convenient than the quill and the ink pen, because first of all, it is very portable. You can carry it anywhere, and you don't need to carry the ink box. It is very easy to change the refill. The writing is very clear, and natural flow of ink is also there. And there is very smooth writing with the ball pen. Though right now quill pen and the fountain pens are also used, but now ball pens are mostly used than both of the other pens. Second is evolution of the telephone. So telephone, the first telephone was invented in 1876 by Alexander Graham Bell's. Afterwards, in 1994, cordless phone was introduced, which only operates by radio frequency transmission. And the range was limited, you know, in the same building or to some short distances from the base station. Later on, in 1992, IBM Simon was the first with a touchscreen. So afterwards, the touchscreen phones were invented, which had many features like you can do texting, camera was there, it was portable, as well as it is now used as a fashion statement. And there are more features like you like entertainment, shopping, games, other apps are also introduced. You can make PDFs, you can do right now Zoom calls and all. And evolution of watch. So the pocket watch was the first watch, which was invented by the Peter Henlein in 1510. The wristwatch was also invented that time, but it was basically invented during the First World War, which was only worn by the women. But afterwards, again, it was invented. For the Queen Naples, so that she can try it over. And soon it got changed into a digital watch. Digital watch was invented in 1812. It was invented by the Hamilton, and they're like, now the digital watch has many features, like it is portable, has GPS alarm, waterproof. It is also as well as used for the fashion statement, and it's basically easier to read. Thank you.
Yeah, it was really nice. It was very simple and beautiful. I really liked it. Okay, can Kavya S present her presentation?
Yeah, sure. Can you hear me?
Yeah.
You are audible. Okay.
Okay, so I chose two products. One was the mobile phone and the other was a handbag. So the first product is the mobile phone. So yeah. So here you can see the timeline of the mobile phone as it started to something that looked resembled a calculator to what it is now, which is a touchscreen mobile phone. So the first handheld mobile phone was demonstrated by John F. Mitchell Martin Cooper. He belonged to the brand Motorola in 1973. It was a very heavy object. It looked like kind of a box and was like 2 kgs. So it wasn't really transportable. Then Nokia introduced a new model in 1984, which allowed a talk time of about 30 minutes. It did not have any major features since it was just used for like calling purposes during emergency times, like during the war times and like for hospital emergencies, etc. And in the 1990s, phones were modified as the sizes of the phones became smaller and the screens became larger. During this period, Nokia also introduced flip phones with like extensive features like the vibrate function and ringtones, etc. In 1993, a new updated version was introduced, which had facilities like the GSM, and like it was then switched to like digital network rather using the old backlog analog system, and it allowed new facilities like SMS and texting. In 1997, the first smartphone term came into being, since it allowed data storage and like 1G facilities that is profitably used. Models released from 1998 to 2000 introduced the world to like different designs and like colors and curves and shapes of like new models came into being. In 2000s, Nokia was, which was a major brand of mobile phones, started to like slip down, since like other brands like LG and Samsung, etc., also came into being. Color screens began to appear, and also the built-in cameras on mobile phones also came into being. It was also now BAP enabled, and it was all wireless, and hence it could access the internet. Designs also evolved, and the BlackBerry phone, which is both touchscreen and keypad handle, came into being. And hence like storage space and like 1G to 2G also, the transformation happened. In 2007, the first ever touchscreen model started to appear, and the first iPhone was also introduced during that point of time. And since like it was touchscreen, you could also like access the internet, and facilities like the GPS also came to being. So this was the point when mobile phones started to become like a kind of like a mini computer to like use things like surfing the internet, like accessing mail, etc. Now in the present day, the internet has like rebuilt the mobile phones that we can use like various facilities, like we can shop, we can pay using mobile phones, etc. And design has also evolved. Now we have like flip phones, we have like the new Samsung models, which are like like the new ones which have come, which have like keypad and like the stylus, etc. And the storage space is also like very unlimited, and we can also attach an SD card and stuff, so if we want like more storage space. And new features like facial and fingerprint recognitions have replaced like the old back time keypad passwords. Market for the phones have also increased since with the upcoming of like various brands, like we have now Vivo and Oppo, which like offer the same models in like a lower price. Since like phones are like linked to social media, etc., like things like camera also have developed a lot. New features like optical zoom and low light and optical stabilization have also come into being. So the second product which I chose was handbags. So the first, the old world's oldest handbag was discovered 700 years ago in region of northern Iraq. Handbags were like originally known as a men's accessory rather than women's, as like evidences of like Egyptian men carrying big small pouches around their waistline have seen. They were only used for like carrying essentials like small coins, since they were like small in size. In the 14th and 15th centuries, bags were exclusively used to only carry like money and like coins, and the term purse came into being. These purses were now used by both men and women commonly, and was attached to something like a belt inside their clothes. During the medieval time, purses or handbags found like a new purpose, and they were used as a symbol, like, you know, when the dowry system and all of that existed, they were used as a fancy quota, and the beauty quota came into being. So new things like embroideries, etc., were like used. In the 16th and 17th century, with the introduction of pockets in women, in men's clothing in 1670, men's back took like a backstage, and like women's bags were more developing at that point of time. And 16th century onwards, women like the bags which are like origin before worn with like on like the waistline, when they now transformed it, and it was like a chain kind of thing called a chatelaine was used. And that you could also like insert small utensils like the safety pins or like keys, household keys, etc. During the 18th and much of the 19th century, you would have seen like many shows that women's clothes are like very extravagant and like big. So like these could like easily hide the small purses that they used during that kind of point of time. So thigh high purses, which they kind of like attached to their stockings, where it came into being during that point of time. With the turn of events in 19th centuries, handbags now became like a sign of power, like a sign of beauty and power, like to portray wealth and like the class system it discriminated the rich and the poor. So then something called the drawstring bags that only the rich women used came into being. And they also had like a new design, like embroidery and jewelries, etc. were like used to show that they were more wealthy and powerful. And in the men's section, men's bag also made a comeback, and the new lexicon bag, which is like a luggage bag, came into being, which like only men used at that point of time. 20th century till the present day, the industrialization and mechanization has led to like manufacture of various materials, like we have leather, jute, cotton, etc. After the Second World War, there was a new influence on like fashion, since like most people did not really have anything to do and they were idle. So like they found new hobbies and like new things like fashion and art like became the movement at that point of time. The size of bags now became like way larger than they were before. As employment rate also increased in the 20th century, the need for handbags and the utilities worsened a lot. So like they needed bags for like going to the market, different bags for going to the office, and like obviously you can't carry a plastic bag and go to the office. So because of this new ventures that we had, new like branches, they had to like develop different kind of bags, like clutches and travel bags, etc. By the end of the 1970s, something called the shoulder bag, which is also very popular today, made a comeback. And the process of like zips and all were like fully done. Before they never used to use zips. It was more like or like ropes or like buttons. After the 1950s, branding became a new whole thing. Brands like very popular brands like Gucci, Prada, Dior, Louis Vuitton, all of these emerged, and like there was like market competition between all of them. In recent times, handbags have now become like they have changed from like the utility quota to like the fashion quota. We see like a lot of designs of bags and like lot of structures ranging from satchels, clutches, duffels, which are used by both men and women. Thank you.
Yeah, it was amazing. It has everything we need for in it. So is everyone done?
Good. It was good. Really good. If anyone done is okay, but look at this as a benchmark. I don't mind if you guys want to take time and we can keep in next session. I will just give the remark for today and we can keep like, you know, next week, because I'm very happy for all the improvement and the way we are working it. I do understand all of you having some exams and things are going on in the school. Yes? No?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Yeah. So see, I always believe the design things need time. It is something which do not comes in a, you know, days, like, you know. So till now what we see, so next time when we walk, we'll improve more. So if I see from where we have started and today, so research part has been done. Now, the guys who have presented today and rest of you also, what you can add on, just go back to the, one of you can go in the this one presentation. Just go in, sorry, just check your group. I have shared you one, the rendered drawing. Did I?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Yeah, so if your presentation is done, you also have a book. What you can do is, after all this research and study, what kind of product you want to make it? Are you getting it, my point? Like, you know, what is next? Like, suppose if I study different kind of the what pen in the market, which is used as a ballpoint pen. So what will be the my product or next product?
Also changes in the design.
That is up to you. What you want to do better? Why people will buy it? Design, aesthetic, something like, you know, did you saw someday before I think a year or 2 years back, I saw one pen at this many kilometers run. Like, you know, I don't remember right now properly, but I'll find and I'll share you the link. So many one, see some brand, they pick themselves and they show that they are luxury, premium, class. So right now in presentation also, I'll talk about one by one. Like suppose Kavya presentation. So somebody, could you please, do not say me, it's very nice. Could you please summarize it? Khushi, could you please summarize the Kavya presentation? What was there in Kavya presentation?
Sir, it was about mobile phones and handbags, like the journey of mobile phones and handbags, how it started.
Okay. Radhika, could you please talk about Janvi presentation?
Sir, I didn't take notes this class.
Okay. So anyway, this video is on YouTube, so we'll share you the link. Just check your friend presentation. You can just scroll forward also and check the presentation which was done today. Check properly. Make sure rest of you present in next class. And meanwhile, if you are done or if you're doing it also, look at this one. Is this, do you have any doubt what I send you in this, the drawing, the process of, like, you know, your design? Is this any confusion anyone having it in this drawing which I send you, the sketch? Yes, no,
sir, tell me. It's quite an unclear sketch though.
See, just for a reference, I don't want to give you the clear idea. What is your, I'll explain you. Can you guys see the three images are here? The first one over here in your chat box is divided into three parts, right?
Yes, sir.
Yeah, the first one is, the one is complete look. Second is different side of the object, how it is, how you hold, how you press, how it works, correct? Yes. Anyone having a problem or confusion till now? What is there?
No.
What
sir.
Is this, by the way? What is this? What we call?
Nail cutter.
Nail cutter?
It's a stapler.
It looks like a nail cutter.
Yeah, it is a stapler. Right. Okay, what is the difference between a stapler and punch machine?
Punch machine is like used to like make holes in paper, and like staplers used to like staple like bundles of paper together.
Yeah. Kind of just opposite, na? But similar work. Indirectly. Kind of after the hole, there also you tie all the paper, right? Or you use somewhere. But interesting, punch machine and like, you know, the stapler. I did once the project on it. Then next one, second page, if you will see, there you have a detailed, okay, what product you use inside of it, how you open, what all mechanism is there inside, you know, that's more detailed in the last one. Can you see? Every part is segregated, open, and it's there as a drawing, correct? Yes, no, tell me.
Yes, sir.
Yes, are you guys sir. Feeling now okay? What is this? So the idea was to giving you this one inspiration or example to just to get the idea. What is here, you can see the journey. So the way I explain you, it is clear now? What is there in this?
Yes, sir.
Yeah, so any object, what all you can visualize, water bottle also, the cap is there, opening part is there. Then the below bottom, how it looks in between, what kind of design. So divide the all design in separate part. Then assemble it together. That also one image you should have. try to draw inside of the bottle also how the texture look. Don't say I have a one, like, you know, shape only. Getting it?
Yes, sir.
Yes, no.
Yes, sir.
You all have learned the line drawing, object drawing setting in your regular classes. So I'm making sense now. Don't tell me next class I don't know. Okay? You guys can do it. I see the great potential. Anyway, we'll have a presentation, continue presentation tomorrow, next class. So try to submit it by this weekend only. All the presentation in the group itself. Yeah, Radhika.
Should I do one more? Because I presented last week.
I do remember, Radhika. You can continue in the same detailing a sketch one, or else if you want to add one or more object, you can do it. Radhika, now I have explained you what is there in the group. Is this clear now, or still you are having a doubt on it?
Yes, sir. So we have to design our own after the research we have done. Based on that, we should design the next project we think we
should. Wait. We'll go on next step to design. Right now, we have to do kind of a design drawing operation of a product, all detailed of the product. Either I should take a very small product, or I will take a big product, but I have to do it. 1 second, I will show you the example also. Like, suppose if the product is this one, you have a lot of things. You will remove this and you can draw this part, you can draw this part, you can draw. But I said the water bottle or any kind of the bottle, which looks very simple. Still, you can draw so many things. The one part of this cap also, you have 2-3 part. Inside also, you have something here, these textures. Open bottle, inside pattern, then below, then how it looks from bottom, then this cylindrical shapes. Remove this sticker and see how it is. All this drawing you are supposed to do first. Getting it?
So, you want us to dissect a product that already exists.
First we'll dissect the product in a various way. Take the example from this image, which is shared in the group again and again. Make sure CR today, because you are heading the class. Write these things, what we have discussed in the class, that in the group. Okay. And that's how your class will continue. Is this clear now? Till here?
Yes, sir.
Anyone having a doubt?
Yes, sir.
So next class, we'll have two things. One, rest of your presentation. Today, whomsoever our presentation is done, if you want, you can add in your presentation. But trust me, it's very nice. I really like it personally. And well done. If you will do it, such presentation in college also, you will get very decent marks. And such topics are there in your college also.
Sir, next class means next week or
tomorrow, is next week Sunday. Only. Don't worry. No. I want to give you some time, because design innovation needs some time. It is not like, you know, a day you can do it. Okay. Even though you will work 24 hours also, you need time to think on it. You need time. It's taking time, right?
Yes, sir.
Or you can do easily. Patapat.
No, sir. I have exam tomorrow.
No. You guys continue with all your exam tests and all. Okay. Check your time. Okay.
Yes, sir.
I know these are exam month. All the best, guys. Thank you so much, everyone, for joining this.